The Bunyangabu County Member of Parliament Davis Kamukama, who defeated the former Defence Minister Adolf Mwesigye, was sent to Rizira on Friday, where he is still over failure to pay a debt of 69 million, which was acquired from Dahu Investment Limited. Kamukama was committed by the Mwanga 2 Court Chief Magistrate Sharon Nuwaha. Kamukama was arrested by Mutesa Sira auctioners, who delivered him to court after a long spell of hiding. He acquired a loan of 29 million. In 2021, which has accumulated to 69 million due to non-payment. On Friday, Kamukama sweated at court and failed to raise at least 10 million installment to skip jail, as he was asked by the lenders. All money lenders turned the Member of Parliament down over lack of collateral security. Members of Parliament have spoken out on the fate of their colleague, saying many legislators are going through similar experiences. They blame their indebtedness to constituency pressures, which tempt them to run to moneylenders for credit.
It is unfortunate that members of Parliament have those issues. I have not known the particular members of Parliament. However, it is bad to take loans that you cannot pay.
The voters expect us to have it all. I've not seen of a Ugandan who is as patriotic as a member of parliament. A member of parliament will attend all the barriers in his constituency. A member of parliament will construct roads. A member of parliament will save a mom who is delivering on the road.
The chairperson of the parliament, Sako Robert Migadde, member of parliament Bovuma Island, blames some members of parliament for failure to join the Sako, where they can access cheaper credit before running to loan sharks.
They are members of parliament who are not members of the parliamentary circle. But that doesn't mean that members of parliamentary circle don't borrow from money lenders. No, they also do, but it is a shock absorber if you're a member, that for certain pressures, those small pressures, you can easily run to the parliamentary circle.
He, however, says that many legislators missed up the opportunity for orientation of financial literacy because the 11th parliament started at the height of COVID-19.
Parliament in general has always had the orientation, and as part of that orientation, they also do financial literacy. Unfortunately, this time, because of COVID, a lot of orientation wasn't done. But as a circle, in our AGMs and whatever we also do, we also bring some experts for financial literacy.
Father Charles Onen, the vice chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee of Rules and Privileges, says high indebtedness in members of parliament is partially blamed on municipality of wives whom they acquire after entering parliament and stretch them financially.
I hear there are those who are multiplying their women simply because they're already in parliament. They are marrying one wife after another wife after another, and they're just spending money. Financial discipline, it is something which each member of parliament must go and sit down and read that note.
The Commission of Parliament, Solomon Surani, cautioned members of parliament to have financial discipline and noted that parliament is going to make more sensitization of members of parliament.
It is good to live within your means, but we are going to continue engaging with members and we see how it can be sorted out.
Parliament cannot come to redeem a member who is actually financially indisciplined. In this case, the money which we are given, the emoluments and even the salary, it is enough to cater for us.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.